You may be seeing several medieval style covers of pop songs popping up in your recommended bar, including a medieval cover of Astronomia with a cute little visual of the dancing pallbearer meme. It's super tempting to click on them too, because why wouldn't you want to hear what current pop songs would sound like hundreds of years ago? However, it could be argued that the main draw card of these covers is in the visual aesthetic. The medieval tapestry style of the video complements it perfectly by capturing the imagination. And it could be argued that the popularity of these covers have their roots deep in the gooey, messy insides of meme culture. So let's dig in. The year was 2002. Bjørn Kahnbergen and Gerd Jungblut, two German students from the Academy of Media Arts Cologne, created the historic tail construction kit and made it available for public use in 2003. The program used the ancient eldritch technology of Flash and worked by utilizing visual assets from the 11th century Bayeux tapestry. The 11th century Bayeux tapestry is absolutely massive, at 70 meters long, that's 230 feet, and 50 centimeters tall, and depicts the Norman conquest of England. Essentially, since it has survived for 9 centuries, it's no small wonder that this work of art has managed to influence the art form of modern meme culture. As the early 2000s progressed into 2020, meme culture changed and the internet saw changes in the production and style of mid-century art memes. There are plenty of examples to draw from, but perhaps one of the strongest cases after the Bayeux tapestry memes is the Joseph de Croix memes that blew up in 2009. Frenchman Joseph de Croix created this particular portrait in 1793 and labelled it self-portrait of the artist in the guise of a mockingbird. He was known at the time for being a bit of a troll and creating art that went against the norm, which suits the disregard females, acquire money label given to it in modern times. Fast forward 5 years with the addition of other examples of older art appearing in meme culture, and the page Classical Art Memes was born in 2014 when Facebook was far more popular than it is today, and has now amassed around 5.3 million likes. This page popularized the use of label memes in regards to classical art, and is responsible for a lot of the genre's popularity and continued use in 2020. Finally, it's absolutely worth mentioning comedic group Monty Python, which formed in 1969 and with its surreal take on humour has influenced many aspects of modern meme culture. This is no different with the style of taking mid-century art and using it in a humorous manner. Monty Python executed this perfectly, and it could be argued that this style influenced the use of medieval art memes today. In an interview with CNN, Terry Gilliam of Monty Python said the reason older art works so well in humour is because it's a kind of medievalist view of the world which seems to me to be a lot more alive and interesting than most of the iconography of our modern world. This certainly seems to ring true with the current state of the internet, as we are now seeing medieval versions of pop songs fast becoming one of the most popular forms of entertainment today, as long as thousands of different medieval art memes. What meme would you guys like me to give a lesson in next? Let me know in the comments below.
And remember, like and subscribe!